Welcome to the VR Expert Podcast. I'm your host, Mark Coles, Marketing Manager for VR Expert. And in this podcast, we will be sitting down with innovators, experts, and creators transforming the XR world. In today's episode, I'm delighted to be joined by David Cartwright, Head of Sales for UVSAN. He's an out-of-the-box thinker able to find solutions to any problem, and under his lead, UVSAN has seen tremendous growth and continue to expand globally. UVSAN, you might be asking. UVSAN is a company focused on providing UVC light disinfection of rooms and equipment with a key focus on VR and AR devices. First of all, thank you for joining us, David.
Hi, Mark. Thanks for having me.
And first of all, as I always do, I would like to ask how you actually got into this type of technology.
It's a good question. So I've been with UVSAN now for maybe just over 12 months. I probably fell into it rather than by design. Was actually through connections to the directors of a company that I used to work for a couple of years ago. I guess UVSAN was very much in its infancy at the time. And we're kind of looking for someone to help it grow and push it forward. And conveniently, I was also at a position where I was looking for a new role. So we kind of had a chat. I started with UVSAN, loved the idea, loved the product. It's obviously very, very topical at the time, as it was quite close to the beginning of the pandemic. And so something to really, really get stuck into and sink the teeth in.
Interesting. So part of it was the group that you knew is what actually drove you to be a part of it, or had you heard that they were working on this product before?
It's more about the people, I guess, to be totally honest. I'd worked with the guys before, great guys to work with, and I just reached out to see what they were up to and what potential opportunities there were, and as luck would have it, UVSAN was there, and as I say, very much in its infancy at the time. I think we're going to come on a little bit later, but UVSAN originally was never really supposed to be its own business. That sort of was born out of necessity. I could go into that. I know there's a section for us to talk about that in a bit more detail later on.
Well, why don't you say it straight away? I think our listeners are probably wondering what the story is.
Sure, no worries. So the background to UVSAN, it's actually a part of a larger company called Emotion Group. Mm-hmm. And they're a virtual reality location-based entertainment company. They have a number of installs around the world. The biggest one, and probably the one of note, is the install in Mandalay Bay in Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. And this is actually where the cabinets, our VR disinfection cabinets, were actually invented purely for the purpose of disinfecting the headsets at the install in Mandalay Bay. It's a 40-seat virtual reality aquarium with a lot of footfall. So, there's a natural requirement to share headsets amongst users. And with that comes a requirement to make sure that they're properly cleaned, disinfected, you're not spreading infection. And so because of that, the team were actually looking for a solution to be able to make sure that the headsets were going to be safe for the next person to use. At the time, I think the only real product on the market available was CleanBox. Mm-hmm. And much as that's a great product, it could be particularly expensive when you're looking at a number of seats. You would have to go as far as maybe even buying 40 clean boxes to make it work in an environment where turnaround times are key. You couldn't have users queuing up with one clean box to be able to put one headset in at a time. It needs to kind of all be done simultaneously in order to minimize that downtime. Mm-hmm. And keep things moving, as I say. The team went away and actually developed the UVSAN UVC cabinets specifically for the install in Mandalay Bay. And so now, instead of having 40 clean boxes, they have two of the large cabinets. That could actually accommodate up to 60 headsets. But it's good to have the space. They're good for peripherals, your controllers. They don't necessarily have controllers in that particular venue, but things like, you know, iPads and things that tend to get used, they can all be disinfected in the cabinets. And it can all be locked away, put in there, disinfected. The latest cabinets now actually only have a 2-minute disinfection cycle. Beforehand, it was 5 minutes. And so the ones that actually were installed at the time were 5 minutes, and now it's down to 2 minutes. And it has that great ability as well to be able to put the headsets in overnight. They're locked away in a steel cabinet, you know, always secure, always charged. The cabinets charge as well, and always safe.
What I've gathered, so UVSAN is UVC disinfection cabinets. And you said that there's one that does 20, and then you said there's the 30 is the large. Is that all that UVSAN offers at the moment?
There's three. There's in the range, there's three cabinets. We have our VR12, there's 12 headsets, VR20, 20 headsets, VR30, 30 headsets. Mm-hmm. It's important to acknowledge that that's on the basis of a relatively small headset, you know, something like a Pico. Whereas a larger headset, you would fit less in. But the charging ports within the cabinets do correspond to those numbers. So, you know, 12 ports in the small, 20 in the medium, 30 in the large.
And one thing that it says about UVSAN is that they offer 99.99% bacterial disinfection. Yep. How? I mean, I'm not a scientist, but how does the UVC light exactly work, and how do you kill 99.9% of the bacteria?
Okay, so how the UVC light works, I have to give a very brief version, as the real technical side isn't so much my bag. But from my understanding, it alters the genetic makeup of the viruses themselves and prevents them from being able to reproduce and renders them, you know, effectively dead. It kills all the viruses. Any more technical than that, I would probably be guessing, if I'm honest. But in terms of guaranteeing the efficacy, it's actually very well published, the UVC dosage required to kill a range of pathogens. You know, it's UVC technology isn't a new thing. It's been tested, and it's very easy to find the information of what dosage is required to kill certain pathogens. And so we can use that information, and then we can also put that alongside something called a dosimeter. Okay. Which will allow us to see what the UVC dosage is at any given point. And so our head of engineering and technology, Yarik, I think he's now up to over 2,500 tests within the cabinet to check the UVC dose at any given point within there. You know, so we can guarantee how much UVC radiation is at any point within the cabinet, and using the information published, we can then calculate exactly, you know, what log reduction or what kill rate we can boast about.
You briefly mentioned, so he's been doing 2,500 tests. Is this is one of the main things that separates you from your competitors, or you also mentioned the size? What's the main differential of UVSAN for companies wanting to use UVC?
Yeah, I mean, the testing is always a very difficult one to try and guess what other companies are doing and their way of testing things. I mean, I think first and foremost, the biggest difference is the 360 degree surface disinfection. You know, there's companies, I mean, I hate to mention again, but for example, CleanBox, where the UVC light is specifically targeted at the area of the headset that touches the face. And so, you know, the vast majority of viral transmission will happen through where your hands touch the headset, not necessarily through where your face does. And so there's a big difference there. That's not to say not a number of other companies out there, and CleanBox themselves also have a 360 degree disinfection unit. And I guess then it comes down to things like, as you touched upon, the size. You know, we can get up to 30 headsets in one of our large cabinets. And so you kind of calculate that back to a per headset cost, if you will, and then that makes it significantly cheaper. You know, a lot of the kind of single headset disinfection units, you're probably talking $1,500 to $2,000, something like that. Whereas, you know, our large cabinet is in dollars, probably around the $5,500. And so, you know, you divide that by 30 and suddenly you've got a very, very appealing product at a very, very cheap price. And that's then, I guess, just part of it. There's a number of other things. For example, the charging ports that we've mentioned, you know, the device was actually designed to be almost like a new home for your headsets. You know, we've spoke to so many companies where the existing method is to just leave the headsets on charge on a worktop somewhere, you know, there for the taking for anyone who wants to walk past. And so now with a UVSAN cabinet, it could be locked away, charged up. It's secure. All the charging points are fast charge as well. And then you've got almost as an added bonus, you've got the UVC disinfection on top of that, you know, and it depends on the individual company, you know. But hopefully that gives you a good idea of all of the different features.
So you said all these amazing features, and can you then talk about some companies that have been receiving benefits from the UVSAN? All these features, all these things, or how they're using them?
I guess the areas we see the most success are always going to be companies that have a large amount of virtual reality headsets and like a natural turnover of them, a requirement for them to be shared. Universities in particular have been fantastic customers for us. You know, a lot of classes now do use virtual reality as part of their curriculum. And if you then think you have a class full of students that go in, use the headsets, they're then going to take them off. And, you know, early pandemic, a lot of the universities we were talking to, devices such as this would then be quarantined for 72 hours before the next class was allowed to then use them. And so, you know, now they go into the cabinets, 2 minutes later, they're good to go. You know, so anywhere where there's a, I guess, a turnover and a requirement to share devices. They don't go, it's not just for virtual reality headsets. We do have a number of clients where they're being used, particularly in schools where children have access to iPads. They often get shared as well. And again, you know, they can still all be stacked up within the cabinets, charged overnight should they need to be, all disinfected. You know, anything that has that natural kind of requirement to share devices, which is a lot of places, I guess, these days.
Is there any area where you never thought it would be used that is also being used at the moment? Or a client, you don't have to say names, that waste management, something like that, that you thought this would never make sense?
The best one I would guess, and I think we are good to say who it is Aardman Studios. Mm-hmm. They were actually using the cabinets to aid their production of one of the Shaun the Sheep films. From my understanding, the poor guys that were having to do it at the before they got hold of our cabinets were, you know, they would set up the characters, and once they'd done the shot, they would then need a team of people to come in to clean Wallace, clean Gromit, clean Shaun the Sheep. And it's a very, very long process, you know. And now with the cabinets, they're able to place them inside. You know, this is just on the basis of my understanding, but that would disinfect the characters whilst making the stop motion animation films. So a bit of an out the box one. I guess we never expected it to be used there, but there you go.
Interesting. More back to the virtual reality. So I can imagine there are lots of headset manufacturers. They've all during the pandemic seen there's an issue or a need for the disinfection. How have headset manufacturers, AR and VR related, actually been receptive to the UVSAN?
It's been very, very good reception actually so far. The reaction's been really positive. We are actually officially recommended by Hewlett-Packard as a method of disinfecting HMDs. They did a number of different tests without going into too much detail and boring you guys of all the different tests they did. In essence, they placed their devices in the cabinets, I believe, for 1 week to simulate over a year's worth of use. And this is always on. And the main purpose of the test was to ensure that there's no degradation or damage caused to the devices. As a result, we're now officially recommended by Hewlett-Packard and listed in their cleaning guide. Nice. The cabinet's been tested as well by Vario, RealWear are testing them. Microsoft also recently took one of the cabinets to be used in a show. You know, again, they need to display their fantastic products, right? And at a show where there's going to be lots of footfall, lots of people wanting to have a look and test the HoloLens, there needs to be a way to guarantee that they're not going to be spreading infection. Luckily, they chose UVSAN.
Ah, that's fantastic. So it seems to be they're recognizing it, which mm-hmm. is very important. Why do you think UVC disinfection cabinets haven't been the norm? Or to this point, most people, if I remember before the pandemic, the most thing you heard of was disinfectant wipes. Why do you think it didn't catch on before? I mean, germs and bacteria have always been an issue, especially at these conferences. Why do you think they hadn't caught on earlier?
It's hard to say. I would guess it's, as often is the case, that although people can be aware of an issue, there's very rarely the desire to do something about it until it becomes a requirement. You know, and I think people were aware of it before and just sort of accepted it was there. You know, and they've had wipes around and people have used that and been careful. You know, it's only when something like a pandemic comes along where people actually really look at what needs to be done. And then with things like disinfection wipes, it's not exactly the best combination with expensive electronic devices. You know, before you know it, you're going to have headsets that don't work. You're going to have screen mist, all sorts. And, you know, only when it got to a point where you have to be doing this constantly, does it really become an issue. And the sad thing with it as well is that to actually really get the benefit from a wipe, you have to do a pretty thorough clean.
It sounds fantastic. And I imagine you said you've only been there for 12 months. So then what is actually the next steps for UVSAN? What can we expect and what are the plans?
So the plan is to be the global leader in UVC technology, the go-to place for all things UVC. Big ambition, but why not? No, we have, a culture of continuous improvement. We're always looking at ways to develop and improve the cabinet. So there's plenty of work going on in R&D. Can't really be too specific because, as with anything with R&D, it all sounds great until you come to actually manufacture them. But expect the cabinets to just improve. We also have other product lines in the pipeline. And the other product we have is clean room, which I'm really excited about. And just to touch on that, it doesn't have too much to do with VR, AR, so I won't spend too much time on it. But it's actually capable of disinfecting entire rooms, all air, all surfaces, within 10 minutes. You know, so it's just a simple, pretty much a switching on a light switch to disinfect an entire room.
Impressive.
You know, it's worth mentioning. It has to be unoccupied. Obviously, there's dangers with UVC. we've gone above and beyond on the safety as well. So it's actually combined with what we're calling a true presence detection system.
Okay.
And that relies on things like heat, air pressure, air humidity, movement, all sorts, all combined into one to guarantee that actually the room is empty and safe to use. And so, yeah, really excited about that one. And that's available now as well.
That's, I mean, all those sensors jab into one small device. I have to admit it, that's more than you would expect. I've seen it. It's basically can fit in both of your hands, right? It's miniature.
Well, the sensor itself is, it'll probably be ceiling mounted. It will depend on the install. But it would be a fixed installation, something. If you imagine like a much bigger smoke alarm sort of thing, but far more technical than a smoke alarm. it's installed within the rooms. Hopefully that makes sense.
No, that's very exciting. Then for the listeners, where can they find UVSAN online?
So you can go to uvsan.com. You find all the information there. Of course, we have products available through our resellers, one of the best being VR Expert. So you can find us listed on there as well.
Thank you very much. And then for the listeners who want to keep up with you, where can they find you online?
Me?
Yeah, the head of sales.
I guess LinkedIn is probably the... Yes, sure. LinkedIn is probably the best way to find me, or you could by all means drop me an email, david.cartwright@uvsan.com.
Ah, that's fantastic. Well, David, thank you very much for taking the time out to be part of the podcast. We hope everyone listening enjoyed it. And if you have any questions for us or David, I will have his email and his LinkedIn in the description. And from us today, it's over. Have a very nice day, and till the next time.